Oh, you don't want to be on camera? Someone's camera shy, you're in speaker's corner?
Exactly. You can call me
funny guy.
We'll just have a conversation.
If they have confidence in my knowledge, then I'll go in there. And I advise you guys...
Don't worry, just talk.
Let me explain what the challenge is, okay? This gentleman that I'm having a conversation with has said, I've just read him Sura 424, where it says, forbidden for you are married women
except those for
your right hand's
possess. Who translated it?
In other words,
who translated that?
Muhammad was saying that you can't be with married women, but sex slaves, married sex slaves, that's fine. Okay? And that's also backed up by the hadith that you read earlier, brother, where the companions were hesitant about sleeping with married women.
Who translated that?
And then Allah sends down this revelation of Surah 424. In other words, Allah wants to reassure the companions of Muhammad that sleeping with married sex slaves is fine. And we're asking this in the context of, is it okay to rape in Islam? And this is one way that it can be justified because of the actions of Muhammad and his companions. I'm waiting for this friend here for at least five minutes, saying I've got no knowledge. He's saying,
Liz,
who translated it?
He's
diverting. He is diverting.
Liz, you don't know what you're talking about.
He's diverting.
Okay, prove
he says, I don't know.
Liz,
he
you
says,
have
I don't know
no
what.
No idea.
Let's
what
say
you're
that again. Can you just say that for the camera?
No, can you not put it in
the
camera?
He says, I don't know what I'm talking about. He says, I've got no knowledge. But, and yet, this is an educated Muslim. He likes to tell me how much knowledge he's got. And he's telling me. He's telling me. I'm not educated. I'm not educated. You guys are my religion, but I'm not educated. Okay, sure. She's exposing what she's saying, what your religion says. You don't know what you're talking about. Prove her wrong, then.
We'll prove you wrong. Let's go back to the beginning. Yeah.
Yeah.
Can you not?
I'm not. I'm just here.
No.
Trust me.
Point it to her. Let.
How I'm pointing
to her. Can you feel the back of your head?
No. It's pointed to you. Because you're preaching. We're pointing to you. We'll ask you the question.
This guy's scared.
And then, do you know what I mean?
Are you an illegal immigrant?
I'll be a bit like a muse.
Okay, so here's the thing. Yeah? Here's the thing. What you've just said. Okay, you're now gonna bring it. You're now gonna
undermine
what I've just said.
Listen,
please go ahead.
We're gonna repeat what you said. Yeah.
Yeah, go
okay.
It's
not
the ayah that you used. What ayah number is it?
424.
What translation is it?
It's in the
That's
Lanikon,
not refuting
it's
her.
In Pictor.
That's not refuting
it's in,
her.
Yusuf Ali.
You don't give
it's in Sahih International.
How did you come in?
Refute the theology.
Refute
the theology.
With no patience.
Because we don't need
lies.
Issue.
And in the Arabic, it says what I've said.
Okay. Do you know anything about Islamic studies?
Prove it wrong.
No, I'm waiting for you to tell me.
Prove it. He doesn't know. He just has a private bag and he doesn't know.
You're diverting. And you're asking me about Islamic studies. I'm not here to talk about Islamic studies.
In order for
this
you,
is one
in
very
order
simple
for you to,
issue.
In order for you,
the very simple issue is I've given you this
let
verse. Let me read it to you.
Yes. Let's
okay.
read it.
This is a translation.
She's taking it.
She's taking the Quran out. Yeah.
Okay.
And
also,
she's reading what the Quran says.
Forbidden are women
and you
already
have
married,
nothing.
Except those slaves.
Take it out then.
Whom your right hand possesses.
You have no knowledge of what you're talking about.
Okay. All right. Then go.
No knowledge.
You're not interested. She's taking the Quran out and she's reading what it says.
Forbidden are women already married, except those slaves whom your right hand possess.
Mm-hmm.
Thus has Allah ordained for you. Okay. All others are lawful, provided you seek them in marriage and mar and all the rest of them.
Exactly.
Okay. Now, sorry. Have you got on you that hadith that you read earlier from the ladder?
No, she has. I don't know. But Sahih Muslim 3344.
Thank you, Dagan.
Sahih Muslim, in that hadith, which is directly about this verse being revealed, it says, let me repeat myself, it says how Muhammad's companions were hesitant about sleeping with the married slaves, and then Muhammad gets a revelation that is meant to reassure them, because they probably felt a bit bad. I can imagine them feeling conscience-stricken.
Whose interpretation is this? I don't want
to
know your interpretation.
Sunan Abu Dawud.
No disrespect. I have no respect for your interpretation.
Give the reference.
I have
give
no
the reference
respect
for
your
the
interpretation.
Camera. I'll tell you. Lizzie,
I have no respect
Sunan
for your
Abu
interpretation.
Sunan Abu Dawud 2150. Say it.
Sunan Abu Dawud 2150.
Sahih Muslim 3433.
3433.
There you go. Go and check it.
Is it authentic or is it?
Yes, it's Sahih. It's Sahih.
No.
We've answered all your questions.
You have nothing to say.
Sorry, Sahih doesn't mean authentic.
Sahih doesn't mean authentic.
That doesn't even make sense. What are you talking about? Is it authentic or is it?
It's Sahih. It's Sahih.
Who made it Sahih?
Both of them are Sahih.
Who said it's Sahih?
The tradition say that
who
it's
Sahih. Who said?
Sunan Abu Dawud and Sahih Muslim.
I don't know. Your people who grade hadith.
Yes.
Your people who grade hadith.
Okay, prove us wrong then.
Dawud has got Sahih and he's got non-Sahih. Yes or no?
Which one is non-Sahih? Tell me.
We don't know. You have to go to the
Oh, we don't know.
But you brought
you need to be on camera, bro.
Wait, bro,
you're in speaker's corner, bro.
Stop being silly,
you're in speaker's corner.
It's in Arabic.
Hey.
It's in Abu Dawud and it's in Muslim. Okay, it's in Abu Dawud and it's in Muslim.
Abu Dawud is in Muslim. Are you aware? Some in Dawud are weak. Yes or no?
Okay, is this one weak?
Let me answer this.
Do you know if this one is authentic or weak? Do you know?
Right.
She said it's authentic.
I think it's authentic.
Come on, listen.
But here's the thing, sir. Here's the thing. Actually, Muslims shouldn't say at all, ever, oh, this is a good one, this is a bad one. Yeah. Do you know why?
Because we actually differentiate. As Muslims, we say this one is bad, this one is wrong, this one could come from prophets.
Yeah, when you don't like it.
We're honest about our things.
Relax, sir. You're getting very agitated.
Sorry. Yeah, relax.
Good. Right. Bukhari, we know, chucked out 98% of the hadith he had anyway. Okay, he chucked out 98% of them. And the fact that it survived as a hadith meant that it got a pass. Do you know what I mean? Like A, B, C, it's still a pass. It's not a fail. And you have Muslim scholars out there. Wait, let me finish. Who's saying, okay, so none of these have been Bukhari, okay? But for the sake of argument, okay, the people who came later with their grading system, they were even further away in time from the hadith writers. They were even further away from the life of Muhammad.
What are you talking about?
Why on earth?
What are you talking about?
Do we think that they have the knowledge to grade something weak or strong or whatever?
She's answering your question and you're not interested.
This is a science.
This is science you have no knowledge of.
This is a field you have no knowledge of. I call it fiction. This is a field you don't know what you're talking about. I'm going to put you on camera. Stop being silly.
Show us sources then. If you don't show us sources, I'm going to put you on camera.
Sir?
If you don't show us sources, I'm going to put you on camera.
I wouldn't even come here.
Either way, you're diverting.
Show us sources. Give us sources.
Because in two separate hadith collections, okay, you're diverting because in two separate hadith collections, it says the same thing.
Yes.
Which is that the companions were hesitant about sleeping with these married slave girls, and Allah conveniently gives Muhammad.
Is it authentic or is it weak?
She says it's authentic.
Is it authentic? Is it weak?
She said it's authentic.
She says she thinks.
No, it's authentic.
She says
it's Sahih.
She says it's Sahih.
Wait,
no, she never said
you know
that.
What, sir? Wait, sir, give me a break for a minute. For the benefit of you, okay, for the benefit of the jokes, I'm really in charitable mood today, Daniel.
Liz, you don't know what you're talking about.
You know what? Let's throw out the hadith. Let's pretend you're Quranic, yeah? And let's say, actually, all of the hadith, they don't matter. They're all later fabrications, which I completely understand why
you're saying. She's not saying that.
I'm saying that, but to help you,
Don't help me.
Okay, right.
You don't say that.
Surah 424 still says, let's take the Quran on its own.
Let's take it. Is this an interpretation or is this a translation? Do you read Arabic?
Do you know the difference?
Do you read Arabic?
Anyone read Arabic?
He wants to exalt Arabic.
Anyone
you don't even
know
Arabic.
Read it and translate it in the Arabic? Seriously?
Is this the third member of the gang? I'm talking to you two, really. Is this the third member?
So, what translation is that?
Please do so. Okay, please do so.
Is it, where is it? Darussalam, yeah?
Darussalam.
Yes?
Publishes Riyadh.
Is it Hilali Khan or Muhsin Khan?
Dr. Muhammad Talubdin al-Hilali, I believe he's a Muslim and he's a doctor.
Dr. Muhammad Muhsin Khan.
Oh, yeah, let's see.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And then the Muslim who doesn't want to be on camera says this is not authentic.
This was given to me by a lady who was doing dawah to me. So I think that this lady probably gave me a trustworthy Quran. Listen, I said it's not trustworthy. Oh, it was given to me by a lady.
Did I say it's not trustworthy? Where'd you get it? So is it trustworthy, yes or no? You're rubbish. You don't know what you're talking about. You have no idea what you're talking about.
Everyone here thinks you're mad. You know that.
You
don't know what you're talking about, Liz.
What's your name, sir?
To answer my question.
I'm not telling you my name.
Muhammad is your name, bro. You can't get away from that.
Okay, my question.
It's a better name than my name.
I've been waiting how long? What is it? 20 minutes?
About
for this gentleman who said, who made the claim that he could tell me that this verse, Surah 424, doesn't actually mean what it means.
Yes.
But actually, this hadith doesn't pack it up.
Before I prove anything to you, this is how it works.
Throw it under the bus.
This is how it works.
I'm
still waiting. And instead he's questioning his Quran. He's actually throwing his own Quran under the bus. He's actually throwing his own hadith under the bus.
Yes.
I'm
you're
still
preaching,
waiting for him to tell me that it's abrogated or whatever.
You're exposing your life.
So go and answer me. Okay. Answer me right now.
In order for you to... Stop. Oh. In order for you to make a claim, you have to bring your evidence, yeah?
I have.
And when you bring your evidence...
I have.
Wait, mate. You said you weren't going to talk.
Okay. I brought my hadith.
That's why I know you guys are not being honest,
Muhammad, keep talking. Come on, Muhammad.
Be honest, man.
Muhammad, talk, man.
Liz, you brought evidences, yeah?
Yeah. Where's yours?
What we have to do now is analyze the evidences.
Yeah.
Yes or no?
Yes, go for
yes.
it.
Okay,
we've already lost,
man.
We've already
lost. Very good.
Analyze it.
Okay.
Go for it.
Tell him to be quiet, yeah? And then we can talk, yeah?
No, you know, this is fine.
Okay.
Just analyze
it
for me.
So now we have to analyze, yeah?
Yeah, go for it.
So the hadith that you, the ayah that you brought, yes? Is this a translation or is this an interpretation? Ask the question.
I've answered that question.
Here is the Arabic too. Why are you talking about Arabic if you can't speak Arabic?
Okay. Who spoke Arabic?
Why are you bringing up a translation issue when you don't know what you're talking about? You can't tell the difference between the Arabic and the English.
Okay,
why are you changing the subject, Liz? No, I'm not. I'm telling you on your terms.
Don't change the subject.
I'm telling this on your
terms. Let's go.
You can't tell the difference.
We have to analyze.
What is this? And you can't tell the difference between this and this.
Let's go again.
And you're telling me this is the issue.
Yeah.
Okay, so don't bring this up unless you can defenders.
Okay, we're mad.
This guy, these guys are Muslims.
We're mad for reading the Quran.
Okay, let's stick to the topic.
This is trusted by Muslims.
Let's stick to the topic.
There are no translation issues as far as I'm aware. This was given to me by a lady who was doing dawah to me. I think she thinks it's trustworthy.
He
and
can't
yet
prove
you are
it wrong.
Diverting again.
Yes.
You are again refusing to come with me and tell me how the ayah that I've just read is wrong.
Yes.
Okay, that actually Allah revealed something completely different. Let's just try. Let's just accept that it's not a translation. That
I'll ask you, one question. I'll ask you one question.
Authentic.
No, you're supposed to prove her wrong.
No,
what are you talking about, mate? When you make a claim, you analyze the claim.
Saying something
very different. Have you not studied anything?
Okay, analyze this one.
Have you not studied anything?
Analyze Surah 424. Go.
You've made a claim.
Listen, I'm going to put you on camera, yeah?
Before I prove anything,
analyze it.
You've made a claim. We have to analyze your claim.
Yeah. Go for it.
Yes.
I'm waiting. Go. Analyze. Go.
Let's see.
Now,
your analysis is going to fall.
The translation you brought, do you have in-depth knowledge of the ayah that you brought? Are you
analyzing her or the Quran?
No, the ayah.
Okay, don't talk about her.
Do you know?
Don't talk about her.
Can you bring me evidence of the extended interpretation of what this ayah means?
She did.
Well, if what you're saying is, can I read?
Yes, I can read.
And I've read it.
She's not your prophet. She can read.
You're so weak, man.
Your prophet was illiterate. She can read.
Why are you refusing to engage with the text? Why are you refusing to engage with the meaning?
That's why, Lizzie, that's why he doesn't want to be on camera.
I am shocked.
Because he does not. No.
I am shocked. You have no knowledge of Islam.
Okay, that's it. We can just wrap this up.
You have not given me a single verse. You have not given me a single hadith. You have not given me an argument other than to tell me my translation is wrong.
Other than having a Primark bag.
And you are telling me that I have no knowledge. I've read the Quran. I've read the hadith. And I am shocked that you have no response to this, sir. You need Jesus. You do need to stop trying to defend a book that is indefensible.
Amen.
You need to turn away from a false prophet that tells you it's okay. And I am proud to preach the name of the Lord Jesus in this place.
Okay,
I am going to preach to you because you need Jesus. You are in darkness. Here you are, desperately trying to defend a man who said it's fine to sleep with married slaves. Don't do it. Don't even try. Leave Muhammad in the grave and come and follow Jesus. Repent.
Amen.
Your sins on Jesus. He's died for you. He loves you. He's reigning forevermore. He is the only way to heaven. And if you do not repent, he will cast you from his presence on judgment day. Do not follow a dead man who preaches this evil stuff.
Don't preach to the converted.
Jesus, okay? God bless you.
Don't preach to me. Preach to your followers.